let us continue this discussion. Suppose we look at a different truth assignment. For example, one can set x3 bar to 1, that's what I initially mark, then x2 bar to 1 and x1 to 1, which means x3 is 0 and x2 is 0, x1 is 1. And here is an assignment that is ensuring it is evaluated to true. Now look at those vertices. You pick x1 and pick x2 bar and pick x3 bar from this. So I am saying this is evaluated to true because of x1. This is evaluated to true because of x2 bar, and this is evaluated to true because of x2 bar or x3 bar, but I am considering x3 bar. Okay. And even this forms a clique of size 3, which is K3. Now you see that every truth assignment which is evaluating the formula to true maps to a clique of size 3, meaning it is a solution preserving map. Okay. And if you look at some other truth assignment which is not evaluating to true, suppose you take x1 to 1 and x2 to 1 and x3 to 1. Suppose we do this. Now what happens? This one is false, so which means it is a no instance. No instance meaning for this one, this truth assignment is not correct. I am not saying for this there is no truth assignment at all. You may find some other truth assignment, for example these two. What I am saying, you look at this formula and look at some other truth assignment which is evaluated to false. Okay. Now for this you go here and you look at x1 and we know that x2 bar is 0 and we know that x3 is set to 1. So you get x1 and x3, but from this you cannot pick anything because the formula is evaluated to false, which means you cannot map that to a clique of size 3. This truth assignment is evaluating the formula to false, and this one ensures there is no clique of size 3 for this corresponding instance. So all that I am saying, if this formula is true, then there exists a truth assignment. That truth assignment guarantees a clique of size 3. Okay. Now one can generalize this. Now why do we say clique of size 3? Because there are 3 partitions. And the other thing is, each partition gets a component. So in general, if the formula is true, then there will be C1 to CM clauses, which means you can ask for a clique of size M in this. So the parameter K over here depends on this input, which represents the number of clauses. Fine. So a truth assignment here guarantees a truth assignment that evaluates to true, guarantees a clique of size M. A truth assignment that evaluates to false does not guarantee a clique of size M in this. In this case, if you look at this, which evaluates to false, does not guarantee a clique of size 3. that shows that if this is a truth, this has got a truth assignment which evaluates to true, then this has got a clickup size m. So what is the consequence of this reduction? So we say 3SAT polynomially reduces to click. So on this side, there are n variables and m clauses that is mapped to g comma k. K is m, and our construction says each clause gets a vertex c1, c2, c3, and so on up to cm, and no edges inside ci for all I, and if at all there is an edge, the edge is between xi and xj for all xi xj such that xj is not xi bar. Now on top of this, we demand that it is a solution preserving map wherein if this has got a truth assignment, so the formula 3SAT is satisfiable, there exists a truth assignment that evaluates the formula to true, which means it is satisfiable if and only if g comma m belongs to s instance of the click problem. So if this is satisfiable, then this has got a click of size m, and if this has got a click of size m, then you can map it to the corresponding formula. Each formula is mapped to a graph. So each formula of 3SAT is mapped to a graph, meaning this is mapped to a graph, this one is mapped to a graph, maybe more than one instance can map to the same graph. So like this it happens. Now this reduction tells you that if click is polynomial time solvable at some point in time, then I can use click as a black box to solve 3SAT. So what is the consequence? If click belongs to class P, then 3SAT belongs to class P. So you can use click as a black box to solve 3SAT problem. So you have a formula and map that to graph, and k is m. If this returns yes, you also return yes. If this returns no, you also return no. So that tells you that complexity of click and 3SAT are one and the same. They differ only by a polynomial. If click is solvable efficiently, say in deterministic polynomial time, then 3SAT has got a deterministic polynomial time solution. So they all belong to class P. And the complexity of that is one and the same. They differ only by a little, which is this polynomial time reduction. So solution to click will help you to get a solution to 3SAT. So now that we have seen a couple of reductions, how to compare the relative hardness of one problem with the other problem, let's bring NP hardness theory and link these problems and introduce the theory of NP completeness. And with this you get to know, although we do not solve the problem, we are still able to compare a couple of problems by this polynomial time reduction. So how powerful this framework is and in relating these problems, and what is that we get through this NP hardness theory, and that's something we have seen so far. A little more left on this, which we shall see next.